Parshas Korach, Tovshin Ayin Zayin. Now the theme of Parshas Korach that we've done over the past 7 years, or actually 8 years, but 7 shiurim, will remain the same theme that we are going to talk about this year too. And at least once a year we need to touch upon this subject, because it's something that's very, very important for people to know and to hear over and over again. And the thing that we've stressed all these years is really how much Hashem despises machlokes. And when we talk about Korach, unfortunately, that's the theme of the parsha. The theme of the parsha is the entire inyan of machlokes. This entire episode of Korach and all the men that joined Korach, and we know how it ended up, and it did not end up in a very, very good way. And so much so that when we deal with Korach and his group, Hashem had to create a new punishment. A punishment that did not exist up to that point, and a punishment that was very, very, very strange. And what was that punishment? We all know, you learned the parsha. You see that Hashem had to create the phenomenon that the earth itself would open up and swallow up all the Baalei Machlokes. And it swallowed them up alive. Tremendously unusual and phenomenal punishment, and something that was not there before, and something which I venture to say hasn't happened really since then. And Hashem had to create a special punishment for Baalei Machlokes. And not only that, even young children went down with Korach, which is something very, very unusual, something which is very, very hard to understand. And actually, we spoke about it over the past couple of years, and we've given a few different explanations, and one of the explanations from the Tzivah Shalom was that, of course, the young children that went down with Korach weren't being punished. Because young children don't necessarily, but what it was is that machlokes creates like an infection. And something which is an infectious disease, so it infected everybody else around them. It was a quite severe punishment that happened. And anyone of any age that was involved with Korach went down also. And it's really something that we need to contemplate when we ourselves are presented with any sort of opportunity in our lives to take sides or to be involved in a machlokes. You learn this parsha and you learn it right. The one thing you realize when you get done or when you touch upon the subject of Korach is that we really, really do need to think many, many times over before we get involved or touch any type of machlokes, because it's very scary. And we have to remember that as much as Hashem despised machlokes then, by Korach and Moshe Rabbeinu, Hashem despises machlokes the same way today. It remains the same, which is a very scary thought. And everybody should think of that, actually. And it's people sometimes become so misguided, and they'll give themselves so many excuses to somehow twist things around and say and think that, of course, you know, they're involved in Lashon Hara and Machlokes only, of course, L'shem Shamayim. And we've spoken about this in the past, and of course it bears repeating that, of course, this argument of L'shem Shamayim, if it's ever used, it's used very, very seldomly, because when it all boils down, when we're honest with ourselves, and when we are honest, when we take an honest look at a machlokes or lashon hara or something we want to get involved in, we realize that the vast majority of times it does not constitute anything that remotely resembles the Shem Shamayim. It's all very personal. It's we can't take it. We're basically just sticking up for ourselves. And you know, people run around looking for segulas for everything. People look for segulas, for health, for parnasa, for shidduchim, for good children. So many things. We run around and we look for a segula for this, and then you know what happens. Then you go and you take sides in the neighborhood or political machlokes, and you know what? That really, really doesn't go together. Running around for segulas and brachas, and then doing this, HaKadosh Baruch Hu does not go for that. And you read through the Mefarshim and different things that the Mefarshim speak about on this Parsha, and it's very, very clear that Machlekes doesn't go along with any of it. It's almost incredible that we approach HaKadosh Baruch Hu, or we look for different brachas and segulas when we get involved in Machlekes too. It's a very scary thing. And the Sefer Shalom tells us that there are times in the Torah where the severity of a sin is based, how do we know that an Avera is severe? How does one know? So it's based on the warning and the punishment that the Torah tells us. The Torah gives us an Azvara, the Torah warns us about something, and the Torah also tells us sometimes that there'll be a very, very severe punishment. And that's how we know that an Avera is very serious. Actually, that's one way that we know that an Avera is very serious. But then, here, in our Parsha, by Koyrat, it's different. You know how we know, says the Nesiva Shalom, that the Avera, that the sin of Koyrat, the sin of Machlokes, is so severe? Not because the Torah tells us that it's Aser, and not because the Torah tells us that there will be a severe punishment. It is usur and it's severe because they damage the connection between a person and HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And we know that the purpose of life is that each action that we do and each deed that we do, it should bring us closer to Hashem. And anything done to the contrary is a severe avera. That's the second way people have to look at things. That's something we have to know. That anything which separates a person and distances a person from HaKadosh Baruch Hu is a severe avera. Our object is to always be bringing ourselves, with everything that we do, to be bringing ourselves closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So the Torah tells us here, by Torah, ki niatuho anashim o'ela es Hashem. A totally different reasoning. And we don't find this lashon by any other faith. The Torah tells us that we were instigating, that we were getting involved in machlokes. And you know why that was severe? Because the Torah tells us that, doesn't tell us the punishment. The Torah is just telling us over here that when we get involved in machlokes, that we are going to separate ourselves, we're going to distance ourselves of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And that is the most severe part of Machlokes. And it's for that reason also that the Torah tells us, and when the Torah tells us, let's say, Kedoshim to you, that a person should be a Kedosh, a person should lead their lot, should lead their life in a holy way. And Kedusha, it takes on a prominent role in the Torah. Yet, it doesn't speak about any specific deeds or averas. Kedoshim Tiyu, the Torah tells us, and Rashi tells us in Parshas Kedoshim, that it's talking about Kadesh Atzmecha B'Mutarlov. That you should have Kedusha even in things that are mutar to you, not in things that are aser, because it directly reflects being close to Hashem or not being close to Hashem. If a person leads their life in a way of Kedusha, in a holy way, you're close to Hashem. Anything you do to the contrary will distance you from Hashem. And the worst punishment for a Jew, says in the Sefer Shalom, is to become distant and disconnected from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And there are a few things that we see in the Torah. Kedusha is one of them, and Machlokes is another. There are some things that we see in the Torah that when you do them, or you are over them, it automatically distances you from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And the chait of Korach, the sin of Korach, was this kind of sin. Chazal tell us, HaChoylek al-Raboy, One who gets into a machlokes with his Rebbe, kecholek al hashchina. It's as if you got into a machlokes, you got into an argument, you got into a fight, kaviyachol, with the Shechina. Unbelievable. V'cholam is dabek betamim v'chachamim. Anybody who connects themselves, tries to be closer to a Talmud Chacham, it is as if kemisdabek b'shechina, as if you connected yourself to the Shechina. Because Hashem created this world for uboy tzidba. The purpose of this world is to become connected to Hashem. And every minute and every action that we do, everything that we do, is either bringing us closer to Hashem or distancing us. There's no standing still in life. Like people say this about in business, right? There's no standing still. If you're not moving forward, you're going backward. Connection to Hashem, of course, lahavdil, in a different way, is that every action that we do either brings you closer or you're going further. And we know that it says about the Shechina, it says about HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that Hashem is Eish Oicha. Hashem is a fire that consumes us. It is impossible for a person to actually get that close to Hashem. So why do we keep trying? Why do we keep wanting to be Uvoy Sidba? Why do we keep trying to connect to Hashem if Hashem is like a fire and we cannot connect to Hashem? Says in the Siva Shalom that Chazal tell us, Asei Lecha Rav. That is one of the reasons why Chazal tell us that a person should have a Rebbe for themselves. You know why a person has a Rebbe, a Rav, a Rebbe? You know why? Because through the Tzaddik, we're able to connect to Hashem. You can't connect directly. You can't connect directly to a fire. But through a Tzaddik, that is the medium. That is our connection to Hashem through a Rebbe. And what Korach did, and what Korach said was, there's no person that's better than anybody else. Everybody is the same. Equal rights. Starting to sound a little bit like today, right? Everything, everyone's the same. There's no person that's better than another person. Everybody can do it their own. Korach said, we don't need a Rebbe. We don't need Moshe Rabbeinu. The entire concept of a Rebbe, we don't need. We're all the same. So with what we just said, now we understand Korach better. The only way to connect to HaKadosh Baruch Hu is with the Rebbe. The only way to connect to Hashem is by connecting to someone that's greater than you. And that's why people are so serious about having a Rebbe, about going to a Rebbe. People are very, very serious about that because that is your way of connecting to Hashem. And Korach said, no, no, no. We're all the same. So if Korach says we're all the same, then there's no connecting to a Rebbe. And therefore, you're not connected to Hashem. And as we said, the most severe thing that a Jew can have is to disconnect from HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's a little bit of a deeper understanding of what happened with Korach and why such a severe punishment for Machlokes that the earth had to open up and everybody got swallowed in alive. And really, that is the severity of the Avera of Machlokes. And it's something we need to internalize. And today more than ever, you know that the Beis HaMikdash was destroyed and we are without a Beis HaMikdash for close to 2,000 years because of Sinas Chinam. Sinas Chinam, Machlokes, it all goes in the same boat. And you know what? It's safe to say that that is the reason we haven't rectified that. We haven't rectified it yet. And we're busy excusing ourselves. No, it's not really a Machlokes. I'm not really saying Lashon Hara. I'm this person. It's what does it say Lashon Hara? It's not Lashon Hara because I'm doing it L'Shem Shamayim. It's all, sorry to say, baloney. Let's cut to the chase. Let's be honest with ourselves. In order for Mashiach to come, in order for us to get back to Yerushalayim, we need to correct what we did wrong when we were sent packing from Yerushalayim, when we lost the Beis HaMikdash. So let's learn the lesson this week. Learn the lesson of Korach. The Korach industry, they thought was a good industry until it went underground. It was over. Korach, Hashem told us in 1 minute that it's not going to work anymore. Let's learn the lessons so we can finally get rid of machlokes in our generation.